So I got a lot of friends from San Francisco Bay Area, so I'm gonna start up some for you guys there.
Nice.
But don't forget to donate, okay? At the GoFundMe. Yeah, it's in the link. Steve Earle, there you go. over this world, boys. I've never seen nothing like a Galway up to my eyes, I've seen the years and the slow pouring of tears without crying. Now I want to understand. I have done all that I could, see the evil and the good without hiding. You must tell me if you can, doctor. Was I unwise to leave them open for so long? Doctor, my eyes, I cannot see the sky. Is this the price for having learned how not to cry? Cheers, thank you. Okay, one more, yeah? One more song. Okay. Alright. Something that I didn't practice. Alright. My heavens open every time she smiles. Yeah, and when I come to her, that's where I belong. And when I'm brought into her like a river song, she makes me love, love, crazy love. She gave me love, love, love. Sense of humor when I'm feeling low down. Yeah, and when I come to her, when the sun goes down, take away my troubles, take away my grief, take away my heartache, and run a night like a thief. She gave me love, 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 praise and love. She gave me love, love. Daytime. Yeah, neither in the night. when I'm returning from so far away. And she gave me some sweet loving, brightening up my day. It makes me righteous, it makes me whole, it makes me mellow down into my soul. She gave me love, 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 praise and love. She gave me love, 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 praise and love. She gave me love, 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 praise and love. She gave me love, love, love. Thank you. Thank you. See you next time.
Thank you, man.
Thanks.
Thank you, Sabbath. That was awesome, as always. Just such a great repertoire and so much passion when you sing. So we're going to do part two of the story. If you will remember, there he was. Jack was there, and the king had just asked him, "What's your story?" So Jack has to think of a great, magnificent lie in order to get the king to call him a liar. So, usually I jump around while I'm doing this, so I'm going to try to do it sitting down. So the king said, "Yeah, well, tell us your story then, Jack." Jack thinks to himself, he says, "Well, Your Majesty, you remember some time ago there was a great famine on the land, and I went down to Dublin with my pocket full of sand to feed the people. Oh, but they were such a... You went down to Dublin with your pocket full of sand? You think people are going to do that?" "Yes, I did, Your Majesty." "You call me a liar?" "No, no, Jack. Go ahead." "Well, Your Majesty, I took my pocket full of sand, and then I figured they were such a miserly lot, they'd find food elsewhere. So I ran down to the end of Ireland, and I jumped up, and I went flying over England. And I went flying over the Scottish Channel, and I went flying over France, over Italy, over the Mediterranean, and then I landed at the bottom of a coconut tree in Morocco. And up at the top of the coconut tree, in a cave, spinning on his elbow like a top, was the king of the Moroccans himself. And he came down from the tree, and he spoke to me in a perfect Irish brogue. The king of the Moroccans spoke to me in a perfect Irish brogue. Indeed he did. He called me a magist. He called me a liar.
No.
Well then, Your Majesty, what happened next was, the king of the Moroccans came down, was spinning his elbow like a top, and said, "How may I help you, Jack?" And I said to him, "Your Majesty, king of the Moroccans, spinning your elbow like a top, I need from you the loan, the gift, the borrow, or the theft of 5 tons of oats, 5 tons of peas, 5 tons of beans, and 5 tons of barley." "Done," says the king of the Moroccans. He sends his people off to the bottom of the river to get the food, where they keep it from getting wet. And no time at all, there it was, Your Majesty. 20 tons of food there in front of me. Now, how was I going to get back to the people of Ireland, to my own people, to feed them? What was I going to carry in? How was I going to fly all that way again? All of a sudden, on me neck, Your Majesty, I felt a mosquito. I hate mosquitoes. I smacked him. I took him with my thumbnails. I turned him inside out. I put 5 tons of peas in one lung, 5 tons of beans in the other lung, 5 tons of barley in the lower guts, and 5 tons of whatever's left into the brains. 20 tons of foodstuffs into a mosquito skin bag. Indeed I did, Your Majesty. Are you calling me a liar?
No. What happened next?
Tune in a little bit for the rest of the story. Right coming up, we have Eric Peterson and Lisa Gomes. We're going to stop the feed for a little while, give Facebook time to catch up with itself. And then when we come back, magically here they will be on stage. Please stick around. Thanks for your generosity and your kindness.
Yeah, thank you.